Looking good. Yeah. away, beast. We have pressing business here.
Onro, I believe this beast has come to petition the council.
That creature? A Fey Lord does apply to such as this.
You realize we make the laws here, Onreal? Step up to the podium, petitioner. I, at least, am curious what you have to say. Sivan, Speaker of the One True King's Council. State your nature and business for the record, please.
Your nature, yes. What are you exactly? You're not one of the... well, what do they call themselves? The Dran, are you? Neither Fey nor Dran. How very curious. Tell us more about this Earth.
Oh, Nael, you waste our time. The Fey have more imperative matters that require our attention.
Onreal speaks true. Please, petitioner, briefly state your business before the council.
Great power, you say. And why would you seek such entities? Conveniently vague. If you find such magical solutions, do return to us, for the Fey will have better use for them than you.
What he means, petitioner, is that the only power that remains in this kingdom is political. Nothing more.
There is the imposter.
Yes, the imposter may be exactly what you seek, but if so, we cannot help. We have troubles of our own first. You have wasted quite enough of our time, foreigner. The Fey have far more important concerns than you before us.
Onreal speaks true, but a thought occurs to me. Perhaps this stranger could be of use to us. Our kingdom has been thrust into chaos, stranger. The one true king has been usurped by an imposter, aided by someone on this council, no less. But we know not whom. If you will accede, Fey law allows for an independent party to aid our investigation. Perhaps your eyes can bring clarity where our trust has failed. Do you accept? That is wise. You are under no commitment unless and until you choose to make an accusation. That said, should you come across sufficient evidence, you are permitted, within certain conditions, to accuse one of those seated here. And this body will consider.
A great tragedy, stranger. For eons, the Fey and this council have faithfully served the one true king. But alas, his rule has been curtailed.
The imposter, Faelin or Faerun or whatever they call themselves now, placed the king in an eternal slumber from which he cannot be woken.
The king was attacked in his own chambers, behind this very door.
But, of course, we all have our alibis, as you can imagine. None of us were here. This has been proven. Many times.
If you can find any evidence tying one of us to this tragedy or to the...
It won't be enough, Sivan. The imposter still...
Yet, it will be a step.
It means you're not Fey.
Please, Onreal. Stranger, we will discuss...
We do not. This fu-
Peace. Onreal.
I will answer your question, stranger. With a traitor among us, trust has shattered. If any of us were to produce evidence at this stage, it...
And rightly so. Either of you would love any excuse to remove me from the council.
And you do not wish to hold half the council's power yourself, Onuril? You cannot pretend it isn't true.
Regardless, stranger, you so any evidence you bring would be free from the suspicions. We now know that the imposter approached each one of us at some point, whispering promises of freedom and power.
He only said what we wanted to hear.
Can you blame them, though? The imposter called out important truths.
Is that an admission?
If you would allow me to finish. I was saying he called out important truths that we must take to heart. Despite the point, we would do well to address the flaws raised by the imposter. And I find it difficult to cast blame on any who thought there might be a smoother path.
And yet that path has led to ruin. We have made...
Indeed. But our feelings on the outcome are irrelevant. This count... Alas, we...
There is no blood.
Not that we were able to investigate.
At your request, Onuril. I cannot trust either of you backstabbers nor anyone you might call to serve us.
They were...
Regardless, it is unknown even what could harm the king.
And many have... They are among...
Nor those of us who serve...
Nor for the law. On this we all agree. The imposter's plan should never have been carried out. All must be held to account. The king has ruled over the Fae as long as and
some believed he was too much.
More than some.
Indeed. T'would seem his life is more.
Imagine what would have happened if he had. Oh, of course! How could we have been so blind? The genius of this forest.
Please, Onuril. The simple answer, stranger, is magic of a kind more powerful than any here have yet seen.
All the more reason to identify...
Precisely my point. This foreigner may have any number of reasons for accusing...
Which is why, if and when evidence is produced...
And if that evidence has been falsified? Tainted? How do I know one of you has not paid this interloper to act on your...
Onuril, only you assume that everyone is as unscrupulous as yourself.
Very well. I will... Good.
You're back.
As you will, stranger.
Thank you.
Here they come.
Okay, I don't like the looks of this.
Thank you. Here they come.
I trust you. Tread carefully now.
If you accuse one of us, you must have it.
It is death, foreigner. At least for you.
Are you prepared to make it? Then speak.
Of all on this council, you would accuse me? Perhaps you misunderstand your task.
Let's find out, Nyael. Do you have proof, foreigner, of what I have already long suspected?
I knew it!
So what if I did it? You both know the king was a tyrant. He cared nothing for the Fae or our law.
So you took the law into your own hands.
We make the law, Onuriel. Even now, if you could only see past your pompous face, you could see that we have the opportunity to create a better world.
With that imposter on the throne? Hardly.
We do not make the law on our own, Nyael. Nor guided by emotion. You have broken both Fae law and our trust, and must now face the consequences.
That's done with. I must say, I'm already breathing easier.
You are too quick to joy, Onuriel.
And an excellent roadblock to justice. Our path forward is clearer without her. Here, foreigner, a small thanks from the council. Now let us be. We have wasted enough of our time on foreigners and falsehoods.